Welcome to Review Every Ship by CitizenCon 2024. The point is to give an update on every ship since some haven't had a video made about them in years. We'll go in depth, but we won't repeat everything on the RSI website. We'll link to multiple sources of information either in the description or in the comments. We are currently doing the Anvil Aerospace Manufacturer. We continue our series with the Anvil Terrapin. It has no variants. For the price, the Terrapin, as of 3.22, is $220 standalone, $200 war bond, and was $195 at concept. In-game, the price is about $2.6 million. Outfitted with long-range scanners and encased in heavy armor and oversized shields, the U-4A-3 Terrapin can face potentially hazardous circumstances with confidence, making it the ultimate combat scout and reconnaissance vehicle, at least according to Anvil. Our little scout turtle!
It's time to go into my shell.
No.
Turtle.
No,
shell time coming.
You know, a name is...
For measurements, the Terrapin has length of 20 meters, beam of 16.5, height of 7.5, and it is a small ship. Its minimum crew is 1 and its maximum crew is 2. It can carry 0 SCU.
Sub-zero.
The Terrapin has a top SCM speed of 157, which is slightly below average, and a max speed of 1204, which is above average. For maneuverability, it has average maneuverability overall. For its small class, it has below average speed in SCM and above average speed in SCM and below average maneuverability. For weapons, the Terrapin has 1 size 3 weapon hardpoint, 1 size 3 scanner turret, and no missiles. For ship parts, the Terrapin has 1 medium radar, 1 medium computer, 1 medium power plant, 2 small coolers, 2 medium shield generators, 2 small fuel intakes, 2 small fuel tanks, 1 small quantum drive, 1 small jump module, and 1 medium quantum fuel tank. The hull HP for the Terrapin is 113,525, which is way above average overall. And that's most likely due to its armor. For its small class, it's also, of course, way above average. It's actually top 10 of all in-game ships and has the best hull HP of any ship in the small class. The included shields on the Terrapin are 5MA Chimali Civilian Grade C Shields. And reminder, this has medium shields, so it outclasses the small ships in the types of shields it has. And these are front back type shields. The HP is 9,000 and the regen rate is 183 HP per second. The quantum stats for the Terrapin, it takes about 5 minutes and 30 seconds to go from Crusader to Hurston, 8 minutes and 45 seconds to go from Microtech to R-Corp, and it can go about 100 million kilometers before refueling, which is way above average for its size. The claim time for the Terrapin is about 8 minutes, expedited is about 2.5 minutes and 4,000 credits. For amenities, the Terrapin has a retractable cockpit shield, similar to the Carrick, which also adds to its ability to hide its heat signature until it has to retract it to vent that heat buildup. Then it lights up like a Christmas tree for a second.
There it is.
But then it goes back to being hard to detect. It also has a bathroom and a bed. Just make sure you bring ready-made non-perishable food because it doesn't have a food processor or refrigerator, although it does have a microwave. It has armor and weapon storage, of course. The Terrapin also comes with a dedicated scanning station. Now it's time to rate this ship. A rating I rate from 1 to 10. My 1 is only by if you have a unique reason that is specific to you or because you like the looks of the ship. My 10 is basically if you have the money, this ship is almost guaranteed to be useful to you in the game. A 1 doesn't mean the ship is useless or ugly, and a 10 doesn't mean the ship is perfect. Just remember, this is just our rating. Please give us yours in the comments down below. And I want you to be nice. Or at least,
I want you to be nice. Until it's time to not be nice.
My rating for this ship overall is a 5. The Terrapin might end up as the best darn single person recon ship in the entire game. It has exactly what you need to go and see what's out there and report back without being seen. And if you are seen, it has enough armor and shields and quantum fuel to get you out of a sticky situation. Just don't try and stay and fight, at least until this bad boy is able to fit a nice size 3 weapon on the front. But even then, that's only if you can't run. I also love the look of this ship. I like its internal layout. The Terrapin even has this cool looking fog when you walk in. I like the fact that it has all the amenities to go off and even do a little exploring if you want. So then why is this ship a 5? Especially if I like it so much. because of that price, $220. Even the $195 at Concept. CIG, bro, come here. Let's talk for a second. You know that's just plain too much, right? Like, I'm not asking for it to be $50 or anything. And obviously, I'm not cheap because I'm a few levels into concierge. But, bro, this ship should be no more than $150 at the absolute max, considering what it can do. And really, $130 would be a more honest answer. I just think the design is just so freaking cool, and it has those extra shields. That's why I'd give it an extra $20. So that $150 is pretty solid. But since you can't reduce the price, here's what you do, CIG, to make it worth the money. Give it to SEU of cargo. I'm convinced this should be the minimum for any ship with a walkable interior anyway. Next, give it some size 2 missiles or put a size 4 weapon at the front. If you don't want to make it a better fighter, which I would understand, give it some increased data runner gameplay by adding another computer to make that scanner even more useful. Lastly, make it way faster in a straight line when it's in SCM mode. Because, yeah, it's fast when it's in nav mode, but in SCM mode, it's very slow. And I don't understand why the Carrick should be faster in SCM mode than a ship that's way smaller than it and also is made by the same manufacturer. It should be up there with the Carrick. Then, my friend, you will have a ship worth $220. Otherwise, folks, if you get this ship, play the CCU game until you can get it for $150 or less. That's just solid. You gotta pay $150 or less for this ship to be worth it. As it is now, I picture the Terrapin as exactly what it's meant to be, the tough scout that can go into any danger zone, whether that's danger from environment or from people with ill intent towards you, and it will find out what's going on and allow you to make it back to tell whoever needs to be told. Another idea for this ship is to be a hot zone dropship for a small crew. With the upcoming distribution centers, I think the Terrapin can drop onto the top of that primary building while taking fire and providing cover for a few extra folks to get inside the building. Let's not forget this is also fully capable as a little explorer ship. It has a bed, bathroom, and a shower. You can go out and legitimately find things in the verse with this ship. You can't bring any of it back with you, because it doesn't have any cargo, but you can mark things and come back for it. But some of us just want to go out and see what's out there anyway, so that really wouldn't be something that held us back. So if you're that type of person, this might be one of the best ships for you. So who needs this ship? I mean, really needs it. A person who wants to go far and see, or a person who wants to go far and recon, or a person who needs to drop one or two people into a hot zone and provide cover. And that's really it. If you're not one of those three people, you're not gonna need this ship. But need is not something we talk about all the time when we talk about purchasing digital spaceships, because some of them are just freaking cool. I really, really enjoy the look and feel of the Terrapin, so much so that I kind of just want to buy one just because I like the way it looks and the way it feels. But the price, and literally the price alone, makes this ship an earn in game for me. Look, I know you're here for our rating, but if you really want a ship, go buy it. We won't try to stop you, or even better, all ships can be earned in-game once the game releases, and some you can even purchase in-game right now. These are just our ratings, but when you spend, it's your money. My opinion? I would get a Cutter Scout if I needed to bare minimum some scout stuff, you know, just super cheap for the price. And a step above that is the 315P, which adds more amenities than the Scout does, you know, kind of the same amenities that the Terrapin has, but it also has that fridge. But it might not be as good of a scanner. I'm not quite sure because we can't necessarily compare that in a way that actually matters right now. Or I would jump up 40 and get a Mercury Star Runner. You lose the stealthy vibes, of course, because it's a bigger ship, and you lose the armor. But look at what you gain. Decent cargo, ability to take a vehicle with you. It adds data running functionality. However, I will add it won't be as efficient as scanning the same type of data the Terrapin can scan. The Terrapin is a bit too niche for the price, but if you can get it for cheap, it's a solid ship, and other ships have a fairly difficult time filling their niche role. So that's why it's kind of a middle of the road for us, and I gave it a well-deserved 5. All right, that is it for this one. Thanks for spending your time with us. Peace.